Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today in this sixth part of quadratic equation, we will be studying how to determine nature of the root of the quadratic equation.
Here, roots of any quadratic equation, then first we have to find the value of the discriminant. So here discriminant means the delta. Okay. So here delta, it is the Greek word or Greek symbol which is used to represent the discriminant. So discriminant, it is expressed in the form of the Greek letter, that is delta. So delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. So this delta is only the discriminant, value of discriminant, and from the value of discriminant we can determine the nature of the root of any quadratic equation. Okay, and it is that particular formula which we can use to find the value of the discriminant, which is b square minus 4ac. Here there are three different conditions for the roots of the quadratic equation. So if delta is greater than 0, if delta is greater than 0, then the nature of the root is real and unequal. Okay, it is real and unequal if delta is greater than 0, and if delta is smaller than 0, then the nature of the root is not real. It is not real, second condition. And the third condition is, if delta is equal to 0, then the nature of the root is real and equal. Real and equal. So these three different conditions we have to keep in our mind to determine the nature of root of any quadratic equation. Here delta is greater than 0 means if the value of delta is positive. We know that all the positive numbers are greater than 0. Okay. So if the value of the delta is positive number, then the nature of the root is real and unequal. And in case if delta is negative, the value of delta is negative, means it is smaller than 0. All the negative numbers are smaller than 0. Means if the value of discriminant is negative, then the nature of the root is not real. And in third case, if delta is equal to 0, means the value of that discriminant, whatever we will obtain, if it is 0, then the nature of the root is real and equal. Okay. So these three values, three conditions of this delta, you have to keep in your mind. See practice set 2.5, question number 3. In that question number 3, the question is, determine the nature of the roots of the following quadratic equation. Okay. So here in this question number 3, few sums are given, few quadratic equations are given, and it is asked to determine the nature of the root of the quadratic equations. Okay. So we can determine the nature of the root of the quadratic equation after getting the value of the discriminant. So discriminant means delta, and we have here three conditions. With that three conditions are, if the delta is positive, that is if delta is greater than 0, then the nature of the root is real and unequal. And the second condition is, if the value of delta is negative, then nature of the root is not real, means delta is smaller than 0. And the third condition is, if the value of discriminant is 0, means delta is equal to 0, then the nature of the root is real and equal. Okay. Now from, by using these three conditions, we can determine the nature of the root of the any quadratic equation. So here we are having this one quadratic equation, which is 2x square plus 5 root 3x plus 16 is equal to 0. So in this quadratic equation, first we will find the values of a, b and c, because in that delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. So in that formula of discriminant, we are having three different values. That three different values are a, b and c. So a means the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of middle term of x, and the c means the third coefficient or which is a non-zero constant number. Okay, now we are comparing this equation with its standard form of the equation. Say comparing with, what is the standard form of the equation or general formula of quadratic equation? It is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay, so comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we can get here a means the coefficient of first term, which is 2, b means the coefficient of second term, which is 5 root 3, and the c is third term, which is 16. Okay, now we will write the formula of discriminant, that is delta. In Greek letter, it is denoted by delta. So delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now we will substitute the values of b, a and c, means a, b and c. What is the value of b here? B means 5 root 3. So 5 root 3 bracket square minus 4 multiplied by value of a is 2 and value of c is 16. Okay. Now see how to solve is 5 root 3 square. How to take the square of this 5 root 3? First we are taking the square of 5, which is 25. Then multiplied by square of root 3 is 3 minus here 4 to the 8 and 8 multiplied by 16. Okay. Now 25 3 is 75 minus 16 into 8. 128. Okay. Now see, we will find the difference of 128 and 75. 75 minus 128 means we have to subtract 75 from negative 128. So it is negative 53. So minus 53. Now see, what is the value of delta here? What is the value of discriminant? We obtain the value of discriminant, which is negative 53. So negative value of the discriminant means delta is smaller than 0. So say here delta is smaller than 0, comma, therefore the nature of the root is, the nature of the root is, which condition is applicable here from that three above given conditions? Tell me. See, in that three conditions, which condition is applicable to us? Here the delta is negative, no? Means delta is smaller than 0. So this second condition is applicable to us. Means the nature of the root is not real. Okay. So what we will write here? Nature of the root is not real. Say. Nature of the root is not real. In this way here we can determine the nature of the root of any given quadratic equation. See the next sum, x square minus 8x plus 16 is equal to 0, and we have to determine the nature of the root of this given quadratic equation. So first we will find the value of discriminant, and for that we require three values. They are a, b and c. So for getting a, b, c values, we are comparing this quadratic equation with the general formula or standard form of the equation. So say comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. What is the value of a? A is equal to coefficient of first term, which is nothing but 1. And b is equal to minus 8, then c is equal to 16. Okay, now we'll write the formula of delta. So delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Delta is the Greek letter which is used to express determinant. Now you substitute the values of a, b and c. Here b means minus 8, so minus 8 square minus 4, a is 1 and the c is 16. Okay. Now in the next step, see, square of minus 8. 8 8 is 64 minus here 4 1s are 4 and 4 16s are 64. 4 1s are 4 and 16 4s are 64. And here 64 minus 64 is 0. Now here the value of the discriminant is 0. So which condition above that 3 given condition is applicable to determine nature of the root? Tell me. From these 3 given conditions, which condition is now applicable to this quadratic equation? That is the last condition. Means if delta is equal to 0, then the nature of the root is real and equal. Okay. So here we will write delta is equal to 0. Say therefore, the nature of the root is real and equal. The nature of the root is real and equal. So students, memorize that 3 conditions, then only you will able to find the nature of the root of any given quadratic equation. So that 3 conditions are most important. Do it by heart. Okay. One more sum we are taking. Y square minus 4y minus 1 is equal to 0. And we have to determine the nature of the root of the quadratic equation. So for that, first you compare this equation with its standard form. So say comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Here a is equal to coefficient of first term, which is nothing but 1. B is equal to coefficient of second term, which is negative 4. And c is equal to non-zero constant number or third term, which is minus 1. Now we are writing delta formula, which is the discriminant. So delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now you substitute the values of a, b and c. B is minus 4, so minus 4 square and 4 multiplied by a is 1 and c is minus 1. Okay. So see, square of negative and positive, negative number as well as positive number are always positive. Means square is always positive. So 4 4s are 16 and here minus minus plus, 4 1s are 4, 4 1s are 4. What is 16 plus 4? It is 20. So here the value of delta or value of discriminant is positive, no? Positive 20. So you can write here delta is greater than 0. So which condition is applicable from that 3 condition? That is first condition is applicable here because the value of delta is positive. Now we will say that delta is greater than 0. Say therefore the nature of the root is real and unequal as per that first condition. The nature of the root is real and unequal. Real and unequal for positive value of delta, for positive value of discriminant. So in this way, you can determine the nature of root of any quadratic equation if you will memorize that formula of delta, which is delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. At the same time, you have to remember that 3 conditions. First condition is delta is greater than 0, means if the value of delta is positive, then the nature of the root is real and unequal. And if in case the value of discriminant, means delta is negative, so delta is smaller than 0, then the nature of the root is not real. And the third condition is if delta is equal to 0, means if the value of discriminant is 0, then in that case you have to say the nature of the root is real and equal. Okay. So to find the value of discriminant at the same time the nature of the root, you should know about the formula of delta, which is b square minus 4ac, and these 3 conditions. Okay. These are sufficient to determine the nature of the root of any P1 quadratic equation.